I don't think that you can make a kid be LGBT, but I definitely think you can make a kid be confused about being LGBT. And at first, when I started getting requests to talk about this, I thought, okay, is this really that big of an issue? Is this something that's overblown, or what's going on here? But now I feel like I'm at the point where I can't even log onto social media without seeing some new, absolutely insane viral video of a teacher telling on themselves and just being an absolute clown. So now I agree, it's absolutely a problem. It's insane. And let me tell you that collecting these videos was insane. It was a whole thing, but if I had to see them, so do you. Let's go.
Hi, so I have a small dilemma. I am starting a new job on Monday.
I hate
a teaching job.
I hate the shit on our eyes. Are those samurai sword
earrings? Yeah, I'm not a fan either.
I can't decide if that's really...
I hate that I share the same criticism as Blair White, but God, is that... I imagine the point of it is to be distracting, but, like, it is too distracting, all right? That's all I see.
Yeah.
Really cool, or, like, really annoying? Annoying.
So, the kids are going to call me either Mr. or Mrs. Jamie.
All right. Now that we've all roasted the chick on the fucking TikTok, I'm going to roast Blair White. It's not a bad thing to have good posture, but God, is it annoying to see every time she clicks play and pause on this video, she completely readjusts her posture. Like, bruh, calm down.
It depends on what
she just wants to keep her back better than
you, I don't know what to pick.
And she's a mouth breather, bro. You see her mouth? She is breathing out her fucking mouth.
I feel like Mrs. would be easier.
Non-binary bean.
Easier for the kids, but Mr. makes me feel better. But I also kind of want to try mix, but I don't know if the kids can do that. I don't. And then what do they do when they ask me if I'm a boy or a girl? I'm not. I don't know.
Explain that it's young kids too.
It's young kids. My class is gonna be 4-year-olds, so I don't know. And then
so pre-K
I don't know if I want to go by
I doubt
Jamie
they would
or
ask
Jamie
them.
Ray. Because Jamie Ray is the name that I go by
honestly,
now.
Honestly, they're extremely
I don't know.
Random.
Girl, you don't know what name you want. You don't know what pronouns you want. Maybe you should hold off on fucking teaching. That's just so annoying. Shouldn't she be expressing this amount
I don't think
of
that
like
should hold her away from
stress or excitement? Or-
exactly. You struggle with your own identity. Don't get a job.
Yeah.
Yes. That's the strat.
If they ask if you're a girl or a boy, say neither and leave it at that, honestly.
Or anxiety about, like, how am
I
going to teach these kids? How am I going to live
relate
up to
her
the
struggle
very
or their
intense
struggle,
obligation of educating the
struggle,
youth
so
and raising
know.
These 4-year-olds for 8 hours out of the day that they're not going to be with their parents. But instead, you're such a narcissist that you're sitting here focusing on, what do I want these 4-year-olds to call me? What do I want these 4-year-olds to refer to me as?
They are in preschool. She said she's teaching 4-year-olds. She's teaching pre-K. Like, care for yourself in that aspect, all right? I wouldn't want to deal with a classroom of 4-year-olds.
I was thinking of hypotheticals being that narcissistic. Like, of course I'm going to think of hypotheticals that involve me.
Exactly. And of course I'm going to think of hypotheticals of a new job. A job I've never had before. A job I'm just getting into. And it is a stressful job. Of course I'd be thinking of hypotheticals.
Yeah,
I wouldn't be thinking of the hypotheticals that person's thinking of, but I understand why they are, so.
Yeah.
Girl, you're a narcissist.
I don't know. Any advice would be great for any non-binary teachers.
SOS, save our ship.
SOS, SOC, save our captain. Thanks.
It's really annoying. Okay, so this one is a teacher answering the question, what is your opinion as a teacher on students who want to be called a different name but say not to tell their parents? So let's see what this teacher has to say.
I never tell parents, period. On their survey at the beginning of the year when it asked for preferred name and pronouns, it also asked for what you want me to refer to as when I call home and what pronouns to use. So then I just make sure when I'm calling home, I use what they prefer when I call home. Even if someone told me I couldn't do that and I couldn't call them whatever they want or the pronouns they want without parent permission, still do it.
It's a problem that the teacher feels like they have the ability or the right to keep a secret from a kid's parents. And I know people of this political persuasion tend to believe that children belong more so to the state than they do the parents. That's a whole thing because they're so bent on collectivism. But at the same time, it's deeply predatory is a strong word, so keep it in your peripheral, but maybe not like fully attach it to this scenario. But the word did come to mind when thinking, oh, so you're an adult who is keeping secrets about you and a kid's relationship, what you're calling a kid, and you're not telling the parent.
She is like,
She immediately went to child
I know,
predatory
like, and
practices.
she is like giving no leeway in how she is describing it. In your relationship as an adult with a child, and you're keeping secrets about that relationship. Like, it is a teacher calling a student what the student wants to be called.
Yeah. You know,
I
I'd
don't.
be okay if she had the take of, I can't really know the situation, so I'll err on the side of the parent. Like, I don't think that's a terrible take. I think
Yeah.
this is a terrible take.
Yeah. I mean, like, if the kid wants to be called, by specific pronouns and a specific name, like, the teacher shouldn't have to tell the parents, especially if the kid doesn't want them to. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Like, if the kid doesn't want to come out to their parents, and the kid asks the teacher to do that, that's not like the teacher's being weird and pedo and creepy and shit. That's just like the teacher respecting another human's boundaries and what they do and do not want.
Yeah,
Because
I mean
end of
the
the day, the kid or teenager or young adult is still a human. They have emotions. They know what they like.
They can treat them as the parent's kid or as a person, and that's their
Exactly.
choice as a teacher.
She was talking, Blair White was talking about like they like to think that these kids are property of the government and not of the parents. They aren't property of
You're right.
anyone. Of anyone. The only time they'll be property is when they join the military because they're poor. All right? But they're not property of anyone right now. They're not the parents' property. Responsibility, sure, but not property. Like, oh, come
Reduced
on.
rights doesn't mean property.
Yeah, because it's so dumb. Because but she is trying to make it sound as bad as humanly possible.
Oh,
She's
definitely.
trying to
That's her
frame this
angle.
person, yeah, as a sicko, and that's gross. And what a beautiful freeze frame.
At the very least, that's a problem. You're a problem. If my kid was in school and expressing something about their gender or their sexuality, and any teacher felt like they were to keep that from me or hide that from me, I would be at that school.
If the kid tells the teacher to not tell, it's in the teacher's prerogative. All right? That's the teacher's prerogative to tell from then on. It's not something that should be mandated, all right? And it's not even. The only shit that's mandated that a teacher reports is like violence and abuse,
Yeah,
so
and
on and so forth.
there's some school policies. I think in
Yeah.
Texas, Mr. Davis, I remember he said that he had to report even joking threats of violence now every
Yeah.
time.
Yeah, like it's like the only time a teacher will report something that a student doesn't want the teacher to tell is when the teacher has a choice or when they are mandated to. And if they have that choice, then they can have the choice to not tell. It's not like she's making it out so bad.
Whooping his or her or they's ass. I don't know what this person is. I would shut this school down if this teacher felt like they had any more right to information about my kid than I do. I'm feeling really bitchy today. I'm a four.
They do, though.
Yeah,
They.
because the kid decided to tell.
Exactly. The kid has the right to give away the information that they want. You're dumb. You're done.
I'd
Oh.
hate to be her
Fourth
kid.
grade teacher, and I do a lot
Yeah.
of work with social
Good thing she
justice and
can only
equity in my
adopt.
classroom. We have racialized conversations all the time.
I'm sure that's healthy.
Hannah Fannin-Steele am a racist. I am a product of the white dominant structure I was raised in. My people have done an excellent job lifting each other up. Unfortunately, that was on the backs of people of color. Because this is deeply embedded in my history, it is no wonder I was passed down views that are racially problematic. Even though white supremacy can be unconscious, it is constant. Living in this society would have been a miracle for me to be anything but racist. Now that I know I have deeply rooted racist tendencies, I can constantly be looking and listening for how they surface in my life. And when a person of color gives me feedback for not being a good ally, I can say thank you and not get defensive. Something here I said could have been problematic because I'm always learning.
Why are your eyes like that? Are you on drugs? I like how people like
this. Why are you breathing out your mouth?
Are just projections of what they really feel about themselves. It's like these people can't help but talk about how they are racist and how they're so problematic. It's like, speak for yourself. Why do you feel the need to speak for other people that look like you? Example, white people. Not everyone has these internal views. Not everyone has these senses of other races that you have just because you're so hyper focused on it. You're projecting what you are, which maybe you're racist.
You're also internally transphobic,
Miss Girl, but don't speak anyone else's truth because you don't know if it is their truth. It's just really annoying. Because the reality is, when she's sitting there saying these things to her kids, she is putting it on her kids. For her to say this about her being,
I didn't hear her say that she said that to her kids, like her students or kids, whatever. And if she did, it's kind of weird, unless her students are like high schoolers.
Yeah.
Because if they're anything under,
says
then like
some preschoolers.
Yeah, if they're anything under high school, they just won't understand the message.
Yep.
They won't understand what she means, and they'll just take it straight at face value, most likely.
Yeah, tell their parents,
and
hey, my teacher is racist.
Yeah, that's bad. Yeah, because they will take it straight at face value. My teacher went on a 20-minute rant about how she was racist, Mom. Yeah. Like, so if she's telling it to like teenagers and anyone younger, it's only bad because they're going to take it at face value. They're going to fucking take some heat for it. Yeah. All right?
I don't see a problem with their message in high school.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, the message is fine. I think talking about it is cringe, as in, like, how she said or how they said, I'm, like, a person of color tells me I'm not being a good ally. All right, like, if someone were to tell me I'm not being a good ally, I don't give a fuck. I may do things wrong, but as long as I do enough right, as long as I spread my message and the message is good and positive, I don't want to hear I'm not a good ally. Like, that shit's cringe. You're not a good ally. Fuck
yeah.
You. Like,
I think
like
just
no
using
one can
the
be
word
perfect.
Ally is cringe.
Me too. I think the word ally is cringe too, but it serves a purpose, I guess.
Yeah.
But
like they're in a fight together.
Yeah. Yeah. Also, like, God, that just brings me on topic of white savior. Bro, hearing that shit makes me cringe. Like, even if you mean it as an insult. Yeah. Like, when, because you only say it as an insult. And when you call someone a white savior, that means they are a white person who probably has white fragility or white guilt, and they are speaking for black people or just minorities in general to make themselves feel better, all right?
Yeah.
It's the white knight of social justice when it comes to race issues. White fucking, I already forgot the name. But yeah, like... white savior, there we go. Yeah, like that insult is hella cringe. All right, back to the show.
White, that means she's saying the exact same thing back to her white kids, that they must feel this way as well. She's not presenting it as an opinion. She's not presenting it as a theory. You know, you're talking about yourself. So if you want to announce and confess your sins that you're a racist, go ahead, but don't speak for anyone else.
I am an out teacher at my school, out as both bisexual and trans, and a lot of other teachers on TikTok were wondering how I manage coming out to my students. Mm-hmm. And it's a really interesting story. So this was right before the pandemic. I came back to my school after being away from it for a while, during which time I transitioned. So none of the kids knew me as trans, but I wanted to talk about it. So what I did is, as soon as I came back, I joined up with the GSA, realized how many questions the kids had, and decided the best thing to do would be to host a Q&A.
Hello.
So the Howdy. Kids made up a Hello. Whole bunch of flyers, and then one...
We're enlightening... We're watching Blair White, our favorite YouTuber. Do you want to join us?
What the fuck is this?
Blair White, our favorite YouTuber.
You know it.
Blair White. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, look her up. I'll tell you the title of this one. The Woke Teachers of TikTok. This is a serious problem. I love her content.
Hey,
Blair White makes so much good content.
Look at the top right of your recommendations, Spencer.
Yeah, it stays popped up here. It stays popped up here.
One day during lunch, we hosted the tea talk. It was a triple entendre of tea as in trans, tea as in spilling the tea, and tea as in we literally served
them
tea. Oh,
I love spilling the
tea. It was great. It was a huge success. So many people showed up. We didn't have nearly enough tea for everyone. and I spent about 10 minutes talking about the difference between gender, sex, and sexual orientation, and then also talking about my own life story, sort of like the highlight.
And I'm sure everything that she said about gender, sex, sexuality was completely factual and based in science and not biased or part of her particular worldview at all. I'm sure it was not her opinion. It was all just facts, right? Totally.
She has no sarcastic tone.
No, this one isn't as bad as some other ones.
God, she needs to work on that sarcastic tone. She was saying that shit dry as hell.
Yeah.
You're trans. You're trans yourself. This is why I say she's a transphobe. All right. Even though she herself is trans, because she says shit like that, like you're trans, Blair, you're trans. Stop hating yourself.
As for her actual point, that's why it's good to have people on both sides, even if one side is wrong. So people don't make this stupid argument.
Yeah. I imagine it was completely based in scientific fact.
Trump
like Blair, Blair, you're fucking, you're trans, Blair, you're trans. You're beating yourself in on this one.
That I do think it's a bit strange to come out to your students. I did have one gay teacher growing up, but the way that he handled it was like, he didn't handle it. He actually didn't tell anyone he was gay.
I'm a guy.
During school events where maybe it was appropriate to bring your spouse or whatever, he would bring his husband. And actually, that might have been before gay marriage was legal, so his partner. And it wasn't a thing. Everyone just kind of knew, like, oh yeah, they're together. It,
like
but like
Mr.
this
Juarez
whole announcing, like, I'm bisexual and I'm transgender. Like, how about you teach them how to read? Again, it's just the word narcissist comes to mind. Like, why do you think these kids need to know that you're bisexual?
To help them know that they're not alone. If they're struggling with issues, like feeling like or like them being trans or bi or gay. Or fucking non-binary, it helps them know that they aren't alone. And knowing that this teacher is trans can probably let them help them. It'll probably make allow them to think, hey, if I'm struggling with something, I can go talk to that hot-ass trans teacher. All right, bro.
Yeah.
You missed her, Travis. She was killer. Anyways.
on a less wholesome note, also, kids are fucking stupid, so they'd totally misgender.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, like, honestly, they misgender, you just fucking hit them with the ban, Amber. Alright? send them to
the Shadow
D-Hall and shit. Exactly, yeah, because, I mean, talking back to a teacher could get you in trouble anyways, and that's what misgendering them would be, because you're only doing it to be rude. Unless you're doing it on accident. But, I mean, if she
has...
Teachers
often don't care.
Yeah, I mean, like, if you were to misgender that fucking trans teacher we just saw, that you're doing that pure out of malicious intent.
Yeah.
Alright? She was so... She was fine, bro. Absolutely fine.
Why is it important?
Story time. This has been my first year in preschool with a class of my own, teaching alongside another queer neurodivergent educator, and we have been rocking our twos class. We've been talking about gender and skin color and consent and empathy and our bodies and autonomy. It's been fabulous.
Didn't you say preschool? I would be so pissed. First of all, a number of the things she just listed are things that if I was a parent, honey. I can't speak as a parent because I'm not, but if I was, I for damn sure would be teaching those things to my kid myself, because who the fuck are you? I don't know what your views on any of those things are.
I wouldn't want you teaching it to even your own kid You hate trans people, yet you are trans. Also, early sex ed, when kids are very young, and not sex ed as in telling them how to wrap a condom, but telling them what their body parts are and telling them that they shouldn't let people touch them, all right, leads to more kids reporting sexual assault, reporting pedophilia, because they know it's bad. They know it's bad sooner. So, like, it's a good thing. Now, bodily autonomy, I'm assuming what she meant by that. I highly doubt she's talking about abortion.
No means no.
Yeah, I imagine she means no means no, because that is bodily autonomy, shit like that.
Yeah.
But typically, when I think bodily autonomy, I straight to abortion, so I doubt she's talking about that, but, like, I imagine she's talking about shit a preschooler could palate.
Yeah.
Simple and enough shit.
Bonus, they might not get raised into being like redneck fuck your sister Alabama trailer.
Exactly. Or they might not be raised into actually, like, they might not be raised into when they figure out if they're trans, they won't turn into Blair White and transition and then hate trans people.
I won't be telling my kids anything. And second of all, preschoolers can't read. Teach them to read.
But our teaching team is shifting.
I don't think they teach preschoolers to read. I think they teach them the alphabet and manners and shit.
They don't teach preschoolers that usually, unless you go to like a Montessori school. Like mine, like when I went to Montessori school as a kid, I learned how to read from other kids who knew how to read. That was the whole point of Montessori school, was like kids teaching kids.
That makes sense. I learned the alphabet. I learned very simple math. I don't think I learned how to read, but I knew how to read because I was taught how to read at home.
Damn, I played with blocks and trains.
Yeah, and in kindergarten, we did like spelling and shit and writing and wrote our alphabet, shit like that. So I don't agree with Blair White's thing on teach them to read. Like, obviously she means that as like a jab, but like, I don't believe I was taught to read in pre-K. I'm pretty sure I was taught at home, and I'm pretty sure everyone else was in my preschool. So,
yeah,
I think you like to even get into kindergarten, you have to already know like, basic alphabet stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. To get into kindergarten. Yeah.
So, like, most of that stuff would be normally taught at home because some families can't afford pre-K.
Exactly. I know, for the longest time, I didn't know pre-K cost.
Yeah. The
longest time. But, honestly, I wish it were free. I wish pre-K and shit was free.
It should be free, but...
Yeah. But it's good that it's an option. It's good that most people can get that option. And I imagine if you are under a specific income or tax bracket, I imagine you can get it for free or at least reduced, but that's not something I'm too knowledgeable on.
I mean,
but seeing as it's a school district thing, I imagine they would do reduced shit for it. I wonder what degrees you need to be a pre-K teacher. I doubt you even need a degree.
Really, probably you just don't... like early childhood education.
Yeah.
My mom is a communications major, and she's taught preschool a ton.
Okay, but she doesn't have, like, an education degree? Or does she have an education degree? No.
No, she has an emphasis in art and a communications degree.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, so you just need a degree, then. Okay, yeah. Which makes sense. And I'm not dissing pre-care kindergarten teachers. I think they serve a vital role.
Yes.
Because education,
gender, and genitals came up. One of our
the topic of gender and genitals came up with preschoolers.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah,
yeah. They'd be like, "What this?"
They're in the prime stages for literally like exploring their body.
Yeah,
like they're literally in the prime time for that.
Exactly. Do not take exploring their bodies out of context. But they are like, what's this? What's this? You know?
Because they don't know. It's almost like they're just now figuring out, oh, hey, this is a thing. This exists.
Yeah.
You know? And Makes sense. It makes sense. I mean, like, it's something they should be taught. Because for a decent amount of time, I thought chicks had dicks. All right? Because I didn't fucking know. I thought they had dicks, and I thought they... I forgot what I thought about how they shat, but I already forgot, you know?
Oh my god. I don't even think I thought about them in the first place.
Man, I was a curious kid.
You're a whole problem. Listen, I am not saying, because I know there's going to be someone in the comments, well, you know, preschoolers do know what their private parts are. Yeah, for sure. However,
cut.
Who are you to be talking about it with them, and what are you saying about it to them?
Students plainly looked up and said, well, I'm a girl today, but I know that teacher Ko isn't. No, they're envy. And the look on the incoming teacher's face was priceless. She was shocked in a good way, and she just looked around at the two of us and said, this class is incredible, and I am so impressed.
You see how cool she thinks she is because she, like, even knows what... First of all, envy means non-binary. It's, like, annoying I even know that, but you see how cool she thinks she is?
Annoying, like, I have to, like... Like, I had to acknowledge somebody else's real existence. Like, their gender identity, I actually had to, like, acknowledge it, even though, like, if you don't acknowledge my gender identity, you're a transphobe.
God,
that
was another good freeze frame, by the way.
She thinks she was really that edgy ass bitch for even...
It's always a good freeze frame, because I swear she had something injected into her lips. Like, holy fuck. And she breathes out her mouth. Close your lips. Stop breathing out your mouth. You got a nose, use it. Your body was designed to breathe out your fucking nose. Use it.
Is she about to say they're edgy for having liberal ideals?
I don't know.
Knowing what this is and teaching preschoolers about it. And the fact that this preschooler would even know to use a word like that is clearly because this person is teaching them about their own gender ideology. And that is disgusting. Preschool, remember, preschool.
The scientific consensus agrees with the NB person who was just on the screen, all right? So you're dumb. You're dumb, Blair. You're dumb. Scientific consensus disagrees with you. And you're judging her for teaching the scientific consensus. You're dumb.
Cool.
Oh, my name's Josh. I use they, them pronouns in English, A, and Espanol. And I got a lot of questions like this. So how do I bring this up to my teacher? How do you talk to colleagues about it? How do people respond to you? So where I work, everybody was really receptive. They wanted to learn more about it. It's been a slow process, but they're learning more and they're integrating it.
That chain is fucking ugly.
And this is across languages. So I feel super lucky. However, I know that's not the case for a
dedication
lot of people. All I can say is that try to talk to your teacher about it and explain to them
the
that
line.
This is what non-binary people
and
are
the
doing in the language,
too, also
and that
pink and
by not including language
like
this
purple,
in the classroom, it's
the
making people who are non-binary
either,
or maybe
so.
Are non-binary and they don't know feel
yeah, I've
unsafe,
never put that much effort
and that
in
it's actually transphobic
know, right?
And that they're excluding people's identity in the classroom and making them not feel safe when using that language. So that's all I can say. It's really difficult if people are resistant to it, but we gotta keep fighting.
I'm not gonna lie, I don't know what the f- that person just said. I literally, that was like
me
word
either,
vomit
but I
to me. I don't
attention.
Know what they said. Feel free to translate that in the comments for me. I don't really even know. So as if the gender stuff wasn't enough for kids, especially there's also
she doesn't
this
even know, but she still puts it in the video.
Kids being locked
I
in
know,
closets
I see
because
you.
They're not
yeah,
wearing
trying
masks
to pad
properly.
Out that fucking time.
It is the law by Governor Pritzker to let me out of this room. You can't lock me in a room. You can't lock me in.
This kid's gonna grow up to be a First Amendment auditor.
Please let me out.
All right. 100% grows up to be a
oh
First Amendment
gosh.
Auditor.
Oh my gosh! The teacher was physically keeping this kid in the room. That is so disgusting. There's another one.
She thing is she wouldn't care if a school resource officer did it. She wouldn't care if the principal did it. I imagine like it's just because it's a teacher. They have the same authority just about.
I just want like, more context so I can decide
I mean,
to be mad or not.
More context would be nice, but I, with the context we're given right now, I feel no outrage. I'm just like,
kids get locked in the principal's office all the time.
Yeah, yeah, it's like normal. Is the kid in the principal's office? I have no clue. He's somewhere.
If he's in a janitor's in there closet, for... that might not be okay.
But... Obviously, he isn't in a janitor's closet because there's two doors. So, you know, he's in a room of some sorts.
Man, just take a leak. They'll open that door real exactly. quick.
Exactly. Fucking start pissing under the door. They will open it fast. You're out.
That being said, not recommended solution.
How is this a thing? Same. Like, I'm not sitting here trying to say this is something that's like extremely widespread. I don't know, but there's two videos from two separate schools of this happening, so you can only imagine that this is probably a microcosm.
All the context was they were locked in a room. I've been locked in the principal's room.
Period.
Okay, so during third period, we have announcements and they do the Pledge of Allegiance. I always tell my class, stand if you feel like it, don't stand if you feel like it, say the words if you want, don't have to say the words.
Let's go, screw America.
But I actually don't mind that. Fuck America. That's how I grew up as well in the California school system, which is maybe different from, you know, other states or whatever. But, you know, I don't have any problem with a teacher saying that it's your choice.
Decided to stand but not say the words. Totally fine. Except for the fact that my room does not have a flag. It used to be there, but I took it down during COVID because it made me and I packed it away and I don't know where and I haven't found it.
That eye roll. Just the, like, bro.
She was very obvious about it, yeah.
I know. And she changed her posture to do it. I fucking hate it. Like, watch it. Watch her body movement. Like, see, look at her shoulders, bro.
That's not a normal eye roll. That's for the camera.
And
see, like, she moves her entire body to eyes. She is trying to emphasize that shit so hard. I hate it.
She's trying to make sure it's recording.
I know. Like, Travis, you weren't here earlier, but like at the start, I noticed every time she'd pause or play the video, she'd adjust her posture completely. And I'm not making fun of her for having good posture. I'm making fun of her for correcting her posture 24/7. Like, how does your posture change pausing this? All right,
she
I do this.
Four books on her head.
I know. I move my arm like this. My posture doesn't change. All right, like pause, play. My posture didn't change. All right. So why are you readjusting, Blair? Why are you readjusting? Calm down.
I packed it away and I don't know where, and I haven't found it yet. But my kid today goes, hey, it's kind of weird that we just stand and then, you know, we say it to nothing. And I'm like, oh, well, you know, I got to find it. Like, I'm working on it. I got you. In the meantime, I tell this kid, we do have a flag in the class that you can pledge your allegiance to. And he, like, looks around. And he goes, oh, that one?
That's pretty funny.
Yeah.
So annoying.
That's funny.
No, that's not just that's pretty funny.
Like,
that's
I learned that flag is inherently bad if, or something. Like, that's not what I'm saying.
I would even laugh if, like, my Spanish teacher did that and all he had was a Mexican flag or, like, a Spain flag. I'd be like, that's funny. That's funny.
That's a hot meme.
Yeah, like, no matter what, it's funny.
I'm sure people can construe that, but, like,
most kids
the fact
don't
that
even
this
care.
Teacher is taking
yeah.
joy
I'm sure if
out
a kid actually
manipulating...
cared that she'd put the real flag back up.
Yeah. Yeah, if a kid actually cared, they'd complain to the principal, and the flag would be back up.
Kids to pledging allegiance to a flag they may or may not even fully understand.
They can look
and that
the
teacher is
direction.
On TikTok yeah. laughing about how she's lying to her students. Again, I would be
Teachers
very,
lie
very upset
all
if
the
I was
time.
A parent. I love you guys. Maybe
Teachers
you
lie all the time. What the fuck?
Teachers lie all the time.
Imagine...
Oh.
In my school experience, it's like, bro, you obviously didn't get bullied enough as a kid. Like, honestly, somebody should have bullied you harder.